What's up, guys? With all the madness that went on in October, I did not get to review Venom, and that is a movie I wanted to review, so we're gonna do it now. Let's review Venom. Venom stars Tom Hardy, Michelle Williams, and is directed by Ruben Fleischer. What's up, guys? Welcome to another review. This is like a makeshift setup that I got, you know, during the holidays because family's down and everything. We'll be back to my normal setup here pretty soon, actually, but I figured I'd knock a few reviews out for you guys while I got the time. We're going to talk about Venom. And this review will be dedicated to one of my patrons, Brett. So, Brett, this one's for you. Anyway, quick plot synopsis. You know, a plot synopsis on Venom. There are so many different storylines in the comics about the character. We all remember Spider-Man 3 when Spider-Man gets the symbiote on him, and then through him, it gets passed to Venom. Different story in this one. Beginning of the movie, this alien spaceship comes down. There's this like research team led by Carlton Drake, and they are able to recover these symbiotes, these alien symbiotes. Most of them anyway. One of them escapes. And eventually ends up creating the character Scream. But Carlton Drake, let's talk about Carlton Drake for a second. This is our villain of the movie, played by Riz Ahmed. This was an interesting villain, actually. You know, he is one of those, I guess kind of like Oscorp, he's very wealthy. But his ultimate goal is to find a way for humans to be able to live on other planets. And the way they can do that is with symbiotes. But somewhere along the line, Eddie Brock ends up intercepting the symbiote unintentionally. And so throughout the rest of the movie, there's this tug of war between Venom and Eddie Brock. And that was surprisingly really fun. Now, just to take you back, I remember when this movie was first announced, I was excited because Venom is probably my favorite villain out of Marvel Comics, really even out of DC. I love the character of Venom. He's just irresistible. But along comes this trailer. And I guess visually seeing what Venom was gonna look like, I wasn't enthused really. And I think I even made like a stupid post on Twitter stating that I liked the look of the Spider-Man 3 Venom over this one. I was wrong. After seeing this movie, you know, in full, this is what Venom is supposed to look like. This looks like the action figures you see. I actually have an action figure of Venom somewhere up in my attic, but this looks like what that action figure looked like. I didn't realize the approach that they were going to take with this movie, how Venom had his own personality, his own voice, and he would talk to Eddie Brock. By the way, I have not read the Venom comics, so there's a lot of this stuff I didn't know going into this, but they did kind of portray that in the trailers, actually.
Outstanding. Now, let's bite all the heads off and pile them up in the corner.
Why would we do that?
And again, it was one of those things I was a little skeptical about, but you know, it's context. When you see the movie in full, then it all kind of comes together and it makes sense. And really, let's go ahead and talk about the best thing about this movie. And that is not only Tom Hardy, but Tom Hardy and his relationship with Venom. You know, it kind of reminded me of like movies like Teen Wolf, where there's this constant tug of war between our main character and the, I guess the dark entity, maybe even like Anakin. You know, with Darth Vader, you know, Eddie Brock was constantly fighting this darker side. You know, there was this duality. Thankfully, the script worked with this. There was a lot of really funny lines, a lot of physical comedy, actually. And I don't think anybody could have handled this better than Tom Hardy. There are so many, like, really hilarious moments, which I didn't expect. You know, I thought this was going to be more of just a serious type of comic book film. And thankfully, it's not. It's actually got some really funny stuff in it. It's not perfect, but I did enjoy it quite a bit, actually. Also, Eddie Brock, just as a character, before he even gets into the Venom suit, is really interesting. You know, Tom Hardy, the guy's a chameleon. From role to role, he tries different things. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But in this, it really worked, actually. You know, they're not going for the full-on villain type of character with Eddie Brock and eventually Venom. Venom even jokingly tells Eddie that he was kind of a loser on his planet, which I thought was pretty hilarious. But Eddie is not like a straight up good guy either, you know, but he has like good intentions throughout. You know, he's a journalist. He won't always be completely ethical in reaching his end goal. And I like characters like that, actually. I like characters that have, more than one side to them. I guess anti-heroes, and Eddie Brock really does that in spades. If you compare what he did to what Topher Grace did in Spider-Man 3, it's a world of a difference. You know, Topher Grace really just barely scratched the surface. In this one, Tom Hardy actually digs deep into the character, and it works. Also, Michelle Williams plays Anne. She is Eddie Brock's love interest at the beginning of the movie. They break up pretty quickly, though, after Eddie Brock loses his job. This was one of those areas where I was kind of in the middle with the movie. For me, Michelle Williams, she's really great when she does straight-up dramas, but when you put her in other genres like this, I don't think she's as good of an actress. You know, there's something, it's like she's hiding behind a wall and she needs to fully let herself out. She has certain moments in this, especially the moment where she ends up putting on the Venom suit. That is actually one of my favorite scenes in the whole movie. Dug the hell out of that. And then she comes up and she like kisses Eddie Brock.
Hi, Eddie.
And I started questioning, am I getting turned on by Venom? Did I just give away too much in this review? And also, I must talk about the action in this. It's hit and miss. When Venom is actually like fighting the soldiers and jumping on the buildings and all this stuff, it's amazing, actually. I loved seeing Venom, you know, in full force. And he's giving like the quippy one-liners as he's doing it, but it doesn't go too far. But, you know, this movie really showcases how different Venom is than the character, say, Spider-Man. He doesn't really, like, shoot webs like Spider-Man would, you know? It's a much more aggressive approach. Everything about Venom is very aggressive, actually. Also, the villain in this, Riot, I guess Riot is my biggest problem with this movie. First off, he looks way too similar to Venom. And then the big battle that they have at the end, the big fight, to me, just seeing two symbiotes go at it, I guess visually it looks interesting, but overall it doesn't make for a great fight. You know, and I must admit, I actually enjoyed the fight scenes with the soldiers more than the actual final fight, and that's not a good thing. Riot overall to me is a pretty generic villain. I didn't really get to dig too deep into him. And in the end, I didn't really find him that interesting as a character. But luckily, down the road, I am really curious to see what they do with Carnage, because Carnage is an irresistible character. As far as the cons, I already scratched on the cons a little bit with Michelle Williams and the final act with Riot, so I'm not going to go over that again with you. But you know what? I will say this turned out to be a lot better than I thought it was going to be. And surprisingly, I'm giving Venom a purchase worthy. Had a lot of fun with it. So anyway, guys, post in the comments your thoughts on Venom. Looking forward to hearing them. Also, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day. And on Fridays, we do Free For All Fridays, where we can talk about stuff like Venom. If you like what I'm doing, hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and drum them out.